The biggest shock for me when I lived with 20-25 students from New Zealand, and it was in China, and they all walked without the shoes and without socks like this, you know, on the streets in hostel where I lived. And you know, China is good country, but it's not the cleanest place. And they even walked to the shop outside on the street, like, you know. And all of them, 20 people, walked like this with naked feet. That was the biggest shock for me, you know. And I asked them, like, why are you doing this? And they said, oh, it's our culture. Like, in New Zealand, we always walk without shoes. We even drive a car without shoes, I think they told me. I was like, why? But, you know, it's not in New Zealand, like. And they didn't care, you know. And it really was dirty. It's not very dirty, but it's dirty outside, you know. And inside, even inside. And please tell me if there, like, a people from New Zealand. That was the biggest shock for me, you know. I don't have words to explain it, you know. Then Americans. By the way, when I first time saw Americans, they looked exactly as my grandma told me when she scared me when I was an IT boy. You know, she told me, if you won't behave good, Americans will come and take you. You know, so I would behave good as an IT child boy. And yeah, they looked exactly as she told me, like, they had a wolf head, you know, and they had, instead of arms, hands, they had guns, like, you know. Yeah, but the biggest shock from Americans, you know, I saw that they put left foot inside the sink. You know, I don't mean like they put, like, I don't know, parts of chicken or something, but they don't clean plates at all. Like, you know, I'll put some pictures, maybe, like, I'll show you how much food they put there. And they thought, why Americans are so uncultural? You know, when I saw it abroad, like, first time, and then I saw it. But then I understood that, you know, that tubes can be blocked because of this food. And, but then I understood why they do it. I watched the Dexter TV series about a serial killer, you know, and it was in Florida. And he, like, found, and it was like a food destroyer, food cutter inside the sink. But before that, I've never seen such thing in Soviet Russia, you know. So that explained me why Americans are doing it. And it was not in America when I first time saw it, and not in Russia, but there was this such thing which destroy cut left foot, you know. But first time I thought, why are there so uncultural, you know? Then it's very famous that Americans in opposite, they walk in shoes everywhere in home, and they can climb a bed with shoes, you know. They walk inside the house in shoes, and it's very famous stereotype about Americans, but it's true stereotype. But I'll have to say that Americans learn fast, and I invited some Americans to my house, grandma's house, and I didn't even ask them. They removed their shoes in the entrance, you know, so they learned it, this culture. But in America they never do it, and it's like a shock for us. But at the same time, it's also kind of understandable, even it's shocking for, like, people who first time see it. But it's understandable and explainable, because I was in America before the crisis in Russia and Western sanctions, fucking, like, when ruble currency was stronger. So I lived in New York, studied English in New York, and New York is one of the dirtiest cities I've ever been to. But it's dirty in case of trash, you know, some I don't know, from Snickers, Pepsi Cola, like bottles, but in case of roads, it's clean. Ну, yeah, some dried bubble gums, but, you know, I never cleaned my shoes in America, and really, it keeps clean. So, there is no dirt in case... Dirt, yeah, there is no... It's not dirty in case of dirt, but in Russia, you know, especially if it's wind, like, when snow is melting, or it's like fall, very nasty weather, yeah, you always fall in some shit sometimes, if it's not like the center, you know...
Блядь, сука, ёбаный в рот. Блядь.
Like, because they... Yeah, we have a saying in Russia. We have two problems in Russia. Idiots and roads. So, yeah, and... in Russia, you have always to clean it. And maybe it explains why Americans... Because, yeah, Boston is very clean. Chicago, where I've been, I never cleaned my shoes, you know? But it's shocking, still. Yeah, then Germans, like, you know, Germans, it's like I felt, no, Germans, again, don't get me wrong, great people and stuff, but when I ride the taxi with Germans, and you know, they have to pay, I helped some Germans with luggage and stuff, like, but they had to pay for a taxi, and... Taxi, it was an official taxi in some country, I won't tell what country it was, because maybe that German girl is watching me. But the counter in taxi showed it like 477 or something like this. But, you know, and taxi drivers was very polite and it was very big traffic, so he like really spent a lot of time. But 477. It's like, and that currency is 2 times cheaper than dollar, so like, you know, it would be like around $10. So that German girl gave the taxi driver exactly for that money, 4.77, not even 4.80, not like 5, you know. And like, and that taxi driver, he really helped with luggage and stuff, but Germans, they like, how this word is called, like, stingy maybe. Me, yeah, they like, they count every, like, cent, you know. But maybe it's the secret of German success in economy, you know. They don't feed only Germany, they feed also, like, half of the Europe, like, Greece, Romania. So, Germans are good people, you know. But yeah, that was like, I felt so bad before the taxi driver, so I gave him secretly like some, a little bit more money, you know, just like half of the dollar. But they didn't see those Germans. Ah, yeah, and you know, this is not what shocked me, because I've never seen it, and they think Germans and Finnish people are very cultural people. But we have the stereotype in Russia, since my childhood I hear the stereotype about Germans and Finnish people, that they can fart in on the table when they eat, for example, with the family or like with random people, so it's normal for them, you know, and we say like about them, that we think that they say what is natural is not disgusting. This like kind of saying, and for all of my life I think about this, I've heard this stereotype about Germans and Finnish people, and you know, even in Russia, if someone farted, like, you know, for a joke or just accidentally, he can say like, oh, what is natural is not disgusting. In Germany and Finland, they fart even on the table when they eat together, you know, we like kind of give this, we give this excuse. Yeah, like in Germany and Finland, they do it, so why can't I? Yeah, and then like, well, I talked with some Swiss guy, when I traveled in some country, and we like talked and deal, we had a deal like to meet on the first floor after like 20 minutes, you know. It wasn't some big hostel, hostel like 5-floor hostel. And the thing is, I was waiting for him for 20 minutes, but I knew his room, you know. I thought like, why, where is him, like 20 minutes, he is late 20 minutes. And I went to his floor, second floor, and he was waiting there. You know, because for him, it was like a first floor. So like, then I understood that by Russian standards, what is natural is not disgusting. Yes, this is also about this. Roars, we say about Finnish and German people. And because for Westerners, as I understood, first floor starts from the second floor by the Russian standards. They have like some G floor or something like that, you know. So this misunderstanding, can be careful if you come to Russia about this misunderstandings, you know. Yeah, it's like now I know, but before, like, I didn't know that Westerners use this weird system to count floors from the second floor. Ah, yeah, and then with Holland people, Dutch people from Holland. Ah, now they prohibited to say Holland from Netherlands. But all Holland Dutch people I met, they told me they are from Holland. But they helped me a lot, by the way, very good people. But yeah, I was shocked in Thailand. They helped me a lot. But when we went to party somewhere, we took a taxi and we sat on the back in the back row of the car, and they started to use the belt, safety belt, you know.
Ребята, короче, очень интересный момент. Вот голландцы.
Safety first.
Да, короче, прикрепляются ремнями в такси сзади, на заднем ряду.
Yes.
But in Russia, like, people think, like, you know, it's like, if you do it in the back row, it's like, not cool, like, you know.
Not cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't, it's not cool when you die.
Yeah, but when I drove Toyota Corolla, but previous generation, I told my friends to do it, because, like, you know, the body... Like, can...
Die.
No, it can kill other people in the car.
Oh, really?
If it flies in the car.
I mean, in Russia, nobody do it in the back row. One time I did it when my sister was driving. And my sister turned back, like, and she said, like, you don't trust me? You don't trust my driving skills? Yes, but now I do it because of the safety, you know, but I was shocked that they do it like without any even thinking, because if I take a taxi here or somewhere, I think what the driver will think, that I don't trust him or something, you know, and I don't really do it often, you know, I don't use belt in the back row, and nobody do it in Russia. In South Russia, people don't use belt at all, but in Northern Russia, in Central Russia, it's like kind of a little bit more civilized, and at least driver and then front passengers, they use belts. But in the back row, like, almost never. But they did it without, like, you know, it was very normal for them, very usual. So I was shocked about it. No, okay, that's all, you know. But I have a question for you. Like, what if you met some Russians, what shocked you of seeing Russian habits, you know? It would be very interesting to see. Yeah, but don't say something, you know, famous and stereotypical, like Russians don't smile, because it's a known fact, you know, but something which really shocked you, you know? And write in the comments, because I told you what we shocked about Westerners, and tell me, so...